Welcome to ESPN's Holiday Hoops, presented by K Jewelers.
Number 9 Pittsburgh is unbeaten, and today at home where they almost never lose, and a sold-out Peterson Event Center is ready for a rematch with Oklahoma State, which took two overtimes to settle last year. To ESPN's coverage of college basketball presented by Cars.com. And this afternoon from the University of Pittsburgh, the 9-0 Panthers face the Cowboys of Oklahoma State, part of Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers. Happy holidays to you. Welcome to Pitt, everyone. Dave O'Brien, my partner Lenny Elmore. You still get that great defensive pressure from Pitt, that smash mouth style, Lenny. No question, that hasn't changed. Another perfect start for Pitt, but they're playing a much more up-tempo style this year.
Well, what the reason is because they have gotten people in transition. They got a little bit smaller, but a lot quicker up front. But when you talk about the defense, obviously, this is a team that continues to hold opponents under 40% from the field, under 30% from beyond the arc, and they also have committed the fourth fewest fouls in the nation. That's the formula for Pitt's success. But when you look at Oklahoma State, this is a young team that needs some confidence on the road. They're riding a 13-game road losing streak, but they're a pretty good team, and they'll present some problems for Pitt today.
Let's get you to Star Watch now, the outstanding freshman James Anderson, along with a guy you know very well, Sam Young, for Pitt.
Well, James Anderson, another one of those outstanding impact players, impact freshman for the Big 12. Shoots deep, handles well. Pitt's going to have to stick with him regardless of where the ball is. And Sam Young playing the best basketball of his career, particularly on defense. As Jamie Dixon has said, Sam Young has improved tremendously on that end of the floor.
To the starting lineups now. We'll begin with the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And in the backcourt, it's Eton Harris and James Anderson, the McDonald's All-American. The frontcourt features the shot blocker Marcus Dove and the junior Anthony Brown. For the Pitt Panthers, a quicker, faster team than a year ago. LeVance Fields runs the point. Ramon's the senior. In the frontcourt, freshman DeJuan Blair. He's only 6'7", but he's the starting center, and he plays like a 7-footer. It was a great game last year, double overtime. Oklahoma State would pull it out. Jamie Dixon wants it to end differently this year, certainly. He's 31-2 in the month of December since becoming Pitt's head coach. And overall, non-conference opponents, he is 57-3 against them. Has a big one with Duke coming up. And we are underway. Pitt in the home whites, the Cowboys in the black. Great to have you with us. From Pitt, and one of the toughest places, Len, for a visiting opponent in America.
Well, I tell you, here at the Peterson Events Center, 54-1, as you mentioned, beyond with non-conference opponents, but Oklahoma State is the kind of team, as I mentioned, young. A lot of those guys weren't there last year. A lot of those guys weren't part of that 13-game road losing streak. You see the score right there by DeJuan Blair. But they certainly need to be able to play with Pitt, particularly on the glass. Sean Sutton talked about their inability to really sustain and keep people off the offensive glass, and that's really what hurt them.
Here's Harris to launch a three. Boy, they love to shoot them, and it could be a long day for the Panthers if they're filling them up like that. They shoot a ton of them. 470 shots, Len, coming in for Oklahoma State. 191 of them. That's 41% from outside the arc.
Although Sean Sutton will tell you, that may be a little bit too many for them right now at this time of the year to see the foul. And James Anderson, who scored that three, came into this game shooting 48% from beyond the arc.
Sean Sutton in his second year at the helm of the Cowboys. He had his team in the top 25 a fair hunk of last season, but the Cowboys' turnover problem caught up to them. They led the Big 12 in that category, and Oklahoma State, despite 22 wins, was excluded from the NCAA tournament. As Fields is at the line, a 71% foul shooter, and a real key for Pitt, his ability to keep the turnovers down on their side of things. He's only turned it over 14 times at the point.
Well, in the half-court offense, it's LeVance Fields' show. He's the floor leader, and he's the guy who triggers. Sam Young, obviously, is the guy who usually finishes.
Young with the foul there, a little shove. And Oklahoma State to walk it up, as Lenny mentioned, 13 consecutive road losses for the Cowboys. That's getting old for Sutton. Harris outside for Anderson. There's the freshman who's averaging 21 points a game. Marcus Dubnow, the 6'9 senior, will flip it to Harris. Shot clock down to 12. Brown starts his move. Knocked away the quick hands of DeJuan Blair as he reached and picked it off. The corner jump shot, that will be knocked down by Mike Cook, the senior out of Philly.
But one of the things in transition, when you watch Pitt, Jimmy Dixon told us that anybody out there on the floor, they've got about six guys who are willing to handle the ball and trigger. They don't have to look for the point guard. And that puts a lot of pressure on defenses.
Harris, who hit the three moments ago, gives it up with a bounce pass. Again picked off. How about DeJuan Blair, the freshman, with the quick hands?
It's not only his hands, Dave. It's also the footwork to get himself in position to make the steal without creating contact.
And he is a rarity, a 6'7 senior. And also rare that he became the first freshman to start his very first game at Pitt. First one to do that since Ronald Ramon did it in 2004.
And he's also the second freshman, I believe, in NCAA history to debut with a double-double. Did that against Houston Baptist. I don't care who you're playing against. A double-double your first game. Usually the butterflies take over.
Anderson is dangerous outside the three-point arc and also inside that. Brown will launch it. Really glancing off the iron. And Mike Cook with the rebound. Tried the alley-oop there for Blair. Tried to catch it in the paint. He left that pass short. Here's Dub in transition. Right through everybody to lay it in. Marcus Dub with the bucket.
Marcus Dub, normally known as a shot blocker and a pretty good defensive player. Just showed you some skills off the bounce.
Averaging about 8.6 rebounds per game and a balanced attack for the Cowboys, at least outside of Anderson, who has been a revelation and hitting 48% of his three-pointers. So far, he's been quieted by the Pitt defense. Cook trying to make his move. He's fouled. It's 16:55 remaining here in the first half. Back to Marcus Dove.
Well, the 6'9 senior saw an opening, and he saw the last guy, the last line of defense, was LaVance Fields at 5'10. So he figured, why not take him?
Keith Benjamin picking up his first personal. Ramon off the inbounds. Too strong. Oh, a play! What an effort there by LaVance Fields to push it back in.
5'10 on the offensive glass.
Dove again inside. Too short. Rebound battle for by Brown. Flips it up with the left hand. Some shot making early by both sides here at the Peterson Event Center.
Well, Anthony Brown, a junior college transfer. Pretty good score in junior college. And when you look at Oklahoma State, you look at the stats, you don't think they're balanced. But right out here, watching them, they've got some pretty good talent. Seems like a lot of guys are capable of putting the ball in the basket.
Blair drawing that foul. He'll be going to the line here. The personal on Anderson. Back to that tip.
Well, Fields just goes on the baseline, and Eaton just totally loses him. But, you know, what an effort. As you said, one hand gets an opportunity to really square himself, at least his head towards the basket. And, you know, I wouldn't exactly call that lucky because you got to give credit for the effort. But
Blair makes his first. He's averaging 11 points per game. It's 76% at the line, a hometown kid. Went to high school right in the shadow of the Peterson Event Center. And rolls that one in with a sweet touch at the line.
Pretty good touch for a big guy. Came in averaging 82% from the line. And he seems as though he's a complete package. Maybe a little undersized, but he makes up for it with good footwork. Never really allows the defender to make contact with him as he continually moves on defense.
Eaton outside the three. Shot clock at 15. Dove again, slicing inside. Nice move in the paint.
You gotta like Marcus Dove being assertive. Can't let James Anderson be the only guy putting the ball in the basket. It allows the defenses to load up on him. Dove has created another threat for Oklahoma State.
Dove has four. Usually he is a standout defensively. Young trying to make his move, and that'll be a blocking foul. And we have a timeout on the court. We talked about DeJuan Blair living in the shadow of this building. He eventually came to school here at Pitt. He's a hometown kid. He didn't have to travel very far for his college debut.
Tina, could you take a look at these scripts?
Change the bear to a shark.
Gotcha.
The wizard should have a girl's name.
This is good stuff.
These are meant divorce papers.
They're hilarious.
Miss Bay, the snake wrangler got bit again.
Well, I will suck the venom out, but this is the last time.
Tina, you're needed on stage three.
Does Mama have to do everything around here?
Which flute for the angry hippie sketch?
The other one.
Okay.
Tina, the nanny called. Your daughter says it's octopus time.
Thank you. No, the other kind of German shepherds.
Oh.
Oh. And it makes sense.
What?
This is American Express calling about a suspicious charge on your card. Did you buy 14,000 racquetballs?
14,000 what? No.
No problem. We'll take it off your account right away.
You will? I don't have to do anything?
Nope.
Thanks. I can't do it all alone. That's why I'm a card member.
The writer's room is on fire.
Are you protected from unexpected problems? Are you a card member?
Hi, can I help you?
Yes. Will you pretend you're my wife? Great. Come on.
Happy holidays, sweetheart. Something else?
Yeah, maybe not romantic enough.
Oh, pretty.
At Lowe's, we're happy to help you find the perfect holiday gift for everyone on your list.
What about a gift card?
Yes.
Including Lowe's gift cards.
Spend $100 in Lowe's gift cards and get one of these Cobalt tools. Lowe's, let's build something together.
Capital One Bowl Week, December 20th through January 1st on ESPN, ESPN2, and ABC.
What's up, everyone? I'm DeJuan Blair, and behind me is the house that I grew up in, 600 yards away from the Pittsburgh Peterson Event Center. This is Shinley High School, right down the road from Pittsburgh Peterson Event Center. In my career, we went 57-0, and last year I brought home the state title. This is one of my favorite people here at Shinley, my principal, Sophia Vacaris. We spent a lot of time together, but I was never called to her office. This hoop right here is where I got my first dunk at. I didn't believe it, so I dunked 10 times straight after that. Right here is where I committed to college. I decided to stay home and go to Pitt, and the rest is history.
Well, it is history in the making. A terrific young player, the freshman for the Pitt Panthers. I love the disclaimer. Didn't spend any time in the principal's office. Not called down to the office, just for friendly visits.
But if he did, he'd be pretty entertaining. Such an affable young man. You know, brings a lot of personality here. And Jamie Dixon glowing the fact that, you know, this is the first local product that Pittsburgh's had in a long, long time. And boy, what a find.
Yep. A 7'2" wingspan as well, so he plays like a 7-footer. No thought about the three. Up top for Cook. Shot clock down to 15 for Pitt. Mike Cook averaging 11. The senior gives it up. The theft by Byron Eaton. He'll drive on Fields, draw the foul and lay it in. Fields can't believe that he got hit for the personal. But Eaton did it all end to end.
Well, first of all, it began with too much handle by Mike Cook. Dribbled into traffic, into problems, and then nobody back for Pitt except LeVance Fields. And if you're going to make that type of play, if you're LeVance Fields, what you got to do is you can't let him get the ball up to the basket.
Eaton completes the three-point play, an 82% foul shooter. So Oklahoma State opens up a two-point advantage on the Panthers. Pitt ranked number 9, undefeated, perfect starts, nothing new for them. A win today makes them 10-0 for the fifth year in a row. Ramon off the ball fake.
Good defense by Oklahoma State again, getting hands out and deflections. And we talked about that stat. Yes, they turn it over 16 times a game, but they force 23 turnovers. So that 7 differential really works to their advantage.
A leaner by Lalo Ramon, who can play both guard spots. Very good defender. Real underrated player the last several years here.
Yeah, he's been the three-point threat for Pitt, but he obviously has demonstrated that he can go inside that arc as well. You know, has played a lot of his career off the bench, although he's been a starter of late. Looked like a bump there.
Yep, Anderson hit the deck. He was asking for a foul. They have forced the shot. Fields in transition, gets it off for Gilbert Brown, and he's too long with it. Blair with a tough rebound. That brings the crowd alive. Another effort, he lays it in. He was relentless on that baseline.
And that's what Sean Sutton is worried about. Oklahoma State allowing opponents to shoot 47% from the field, and Sean Sutton attributes that to the ability of the opposite team to get offensive rebounds and putbacks.
Well, a tough shot by Terrell Harris, the junior out of Dallas, with the foul as well. But back to Blair, the freshman.
Well, it's all about blocking out, and that time, just too tough is DeJuan Blair. And you talk about the perseverance. Never let that block get in his way as he went back to the basket again. Oklahoma State really has to focus on putting a body on someone. That's been their Achilles heel. Too many offensive rebounds.
Harris, an excellent foul shooter at 89%, but it rims out. The Panthers, a Sweet 16 team in the NCAA tournament last year on the strength of 29 wins. They're scoring more, more of a transition team than they have been in recent years so far this season. The victories over the likes of Buffalo, Toledo, Mississippi Valley State, and Houston Baptist. Could be a tough week for them. They've got Oak State here, and they've got Duke coming up as well in midweek. Shot clock down to 7. Ramon, cross court, into the corner. The long jump shot just beats that buzzer. Keith Benjamin knocks down the 3.
Keith Benjamin solid off the bench. He's a veteran. Played most of his career off the bench. Mount Vernon High School.
And quickly comes up with a theft as well. Flips it back to Blair for the stuff. A lot of his high school buddies in the stands here today. It's a short walk for them. And a quick flight for Blair with the slam. He talked about perfecting the dunk. Couldn't believe he did it the first time in high school. Well, he's done it very nicely today.
You know, HD TV and TiVo HD just belong together. Like me and Duke. I mean, why get a premium HD TV and a generic DVR? My TiVo searches for HD by show, actor, team, and downloads thousands of movies right to my TV. And Duke, he gets me other things.
Wow, he's so cute.
Good boy, Duke.
New TiVo Ho Ho HD. Perfect for the holidays.
Now there are 14 unbeaten teams remaining in America. 7 of those on our family of networks from this Saturday to next Saturday. Pitt is one of those at 9-0, and Len, they've opened up a 5-point advantage.
They've been able to do it with defense. Juwan Blair pretty much not allowing the ball to be entered inside the post. The perimeter defense getting in passing lanes, creating deflections.
Harris guarded by the quick Benjamin, who just had a steal seconds ago. Obi Manello backing out his dribble. Shot clock at 3. They've got to lift it. There's Dove, too short. Here come the Panthers now. Gilbert Brown off to Benjamin. And Pitt will set it up here. With that 5-point lead, 19-14 at home. In a building where they have been pretty much unstoppable over the years. The stop by Manello. He'll pull up and shoot the short range jumper and knock it down. Manello only hitting about 30% of his threes, but it's such a big weapon for the Cowboys. You mentioned a good point, though. Sean Sutton told us before the contest, he wants to see them shoot about 20 a game, not 30 or 33.
Yeah, sometimes that shot becomes almost an easy one to take, not necessarily to make, although makes it look easy. But guys many times just settle for that 3. And Sean Sutton said that he's been working on getting guys to drive more to the basket, put more pressure on the defense, as opposed to settling for the 3.
Off Harris's hand, that will roll out. A turnover on the sloppy pass by the Cowboys. So number 9 Pitt leading it 22-16 over Oklahoma State, a game that went double overtime last year.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Cars.com. Find the right car for you, Cars.com. And in part by American Express. Are you a card member?
The new Philips Norelco Architect, a shaver with flexible heads which pivot and rotate freely to give you a great shave even on the neck. Simplicity is making hard-to-reach places easy to reach.
Kate's texting us from her dinner with Jeff.
You brought her flowers. Oh,
you took her to Chez Francois.
Nice. He went to Jared.
Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry, has 5 times the selection of ordinary jewelry stores, so you'll find the perfect gift every time. Only gold glows.
It's for you.
Do you have brothers?
Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
Your Double Deep Pizza with double the toppings.
Double.
Pizza Hut's new Double Deep Pizza. Double it up with double the toppings and 50% more cheese. Get one now for just $12.99. Double means more with America's favorite pizza, Pizza Hut. Order online.
At Dick's Sporting Goods, we've got gifts for sports.
Like TaylorMade drivers and Titleist golf balls.
Outerwear for the whole family from the North Face.
Plus new styles of Under Armour fleece and cold gear.
And a great selection of fitness equipment.
We have gifts for the outdoor enthusiasts like GPS systems.
And Coleman road trip grills.
Or come see our selection of Crocs.
And basketball shoes.
Plus table games.
And Fathead wall graphics.
If you're not sure what to give, pick up a holiday gift card.
Every holiday season
starts at Dick's Sporting Goods.
Question is, by the time we get to Thursday in a terrific matchup between Pitt and Duke, will they both be undefeated? Here's the list of the unbeatens coming into today, Len.
Well, you look at a couple of surprises. Look at Miami and Florida, obviously a team that a lot of people didn't expect to be able to get to this point. Sam Houston State, listen out for them throughout the season and in the NCAA tournament. That's one of those mid-majors that will sneak up and bite somebody.
A terrific Saturday of college basketball here, but how about next weekend as well? A Saturday to remember. Georgetown and Memphis, Tennessee, and a tough Xavier team that you saw recently. Texas, right now number 5, taking on Michigan State, Illinois, and Missouri. It's a wonderful, wonderful day. We're billing that as our Saturday to remember. And that will be next weekend. Benjamin with an errant toss. Right through Fields. Eaton very quick makes his move, and it's tipped up and in. And tipped up by Anthony Brown, who got a surprise start today.
Well, that time Oklahoma State just outmanned Pittsburgh on the offensive glass. He still had 3 Pitt guys, didn't get over half court line.
Young trying to take the baseline on Dove, who was so tough defensively. He sealed him right to the line, and they turn it over as he stepped on that line.
And going back to that tip-in where Pittsburgh didn't get everybody back, if you're going to hustle back, you've got to get back on defense. You've got to beat your opponent down the floor.
Oklahoma State has won the last 3 meetings with Pitt. Last year, that great game, 95-89 at Oklahoma City. The Cowboys were the overtime kings last year. They played 8 overtime periods. Another difficult move by Dove underneath the basket. Can't get the roll.
Nice delivery, though, by Manello, who just pretty much shook everybody out of their shoes.
Benjamin lost his dribble. Oklahoma State very quick defensively. Dixon talked about that in the pregame. Benjamin too long with the jump shot. Trying to get it out to Young in transition, and a very difficult shot fouled as well as he's hit by Benjamin, and he'll go to the line. We've got a doubleheader of college basketball on ESPN Tuesday night. First at 7 Eastern, Brandon Rush and number 3 Kansas face Anthony Morrow and Georgia Tech. And then at 9 Eastern, Joe Crawford and Kentucky will take on the Houston Cougars. It's college basketball, part of Holiday Hoops, presented by Kay Jewelers on ESPN Tuesday night. What? Anderson going to the line. It's been a very quiet day so far for the outstanding freshman. Anderson out of Junction City, Arkansas. Came in averaging 21 points per game.
Part of it is because Mike Cook has really dug in when he's been guarding Anderson. Really sticking to him.
But quick dish underneath and outstanding pass to Tyrell Biggs, who draws the foul as he got hammered by Brown.
And that defense that Mike Cook has played against Anderson has forced some of the other Oklahoma State guys to really step up offensively. And thus far, staying in the game.
Big scuffles at the line, just 59% from the stripe.
It's hard to believe because when you look at his delivery, you know, he's got that shooter's rotation on the ball.
Now, Lenny's a junior now. Can you correct certain things this late into a guy's college career to make him a better foul shooter?
Oh, absolutely. And he doesn't have much to go, it seems. I think the biggest problem is he shoots a line drive instead of getting arc under it. When you get an arc on the ball, what it does, it allows it maybe to hit the rim, the top of the rim, and you get a shooter's bounce, which will build your percentage a little bit.
Anderson with a sweet three. He's hitting 48% of those. He can pretty much shoot it from anywhere on the floor.
He shoots it deep, and I think that's one of the problems here. When he does get that opportunity, the defender doesn't believe that he can knock it down from as far as he has.
Well, this is the sixth season inside the Peterson Event Center. Look at Young going to the rack and drawing the foul. And here, Pitt is 87-8 all time, but leading Oklahoma State by just one. Well, foul on Brown, by the way, his second length.
26 in a row coming into this game here at Peterson Event Center. 26 non-conference opponent wins. But Sam Young, we talked about him at the beginning of the telecast, the fact that, you know, his defense has improved, but offensively, you know, he has actually been terrific. That last move, almost 19 points a game, was just fundamentally sound. Ball fake, get the defender to raise up and raise the center of gravity and then drive right around him.
Came in averaging 18 points per game. He just got his first point of the afternoon as he makes them both. The junior out of Clinton, Maryland. So Pitt leading it 25-22. Oklahoma State with the ball here.
Look at Mike Cook. Anderson at the top of the key. Mike Cook just all over him. Anderson obviously receives right there, but out of shooting range.
Eaton driving on Fields. Good matchup there. Spins it up. Batted down by Anthony Brown, and a foul in the lane. We'll go against Oklahoma State with 9:02 remaining.
Well, Anthony Brown came into that with a hammer as he tried to keep the ball alive.
Oklahoma State was blown out by both Marquette and Illinois in the Maui tournament by 30 and by 16 respectively. Which kind of makes this a mismatch on paper, but on December 1st, as you mentioned, the Cowboys, they ran right past Washington. It was a 25-point win. The same Huskies team that Pitt barely squeaked by a week ago as Biggs knocks down the first free throw. They won that ball game by one. And granted, Oklahoma State beat them at Stillwater, whereas Pitt had to travel all the way out to Seattle. And Washington got a key man back in Appleby for that game as well, so that changed things. Blair coming back on. Juan Blair, the freshman, so impressive in the early minutes of this one. And so far has 8 points and 2 rebounds and 2 steals.
I think for Oklahoma State, it's very important that they get James Anderson some touches. He doesn't necessarily have to finish, but he is the focal point of the defense. Mike Cook guarding him, almost face guarding him, not allowing him to even get any daylight for an opportunity to receive.
Young tearing down the rebound. The big body of DeJuan Blair, he gets whistled for the personal, and that brings a big grin from the 6'7 Pittsburgh native.
Well, watch here. He receives. And that's a bit of a bump. I mean, you got to allow some contact inside. The officials saw it differently. There was contact, no question about it. But I think you hit the key phrase, big body, and sometimes that works against you.
He said, I hit people a lot harder over at Shenley High across the street, and I never got hit with a personal. Harris dumping it down low. Oh. That's going to be maybe. What do you think? Possibility?
Turnabout is fair play, right?
That'll be number 3 on Ronald Ramon, by the way.
At least they're consistent, and it was probably the same amount of contact.
Should say Anthony Brown with the personal, and Thomas will step off the floor.
And Anthony Brown put that look like, what did I do?
8-12 remaining here in the first half. Hit by 5. Ramon looking inside, finds Cook. Inside, couldn't get that one to roll in. Blair battles and battles and battles, and he now has 10. Eaton to the baseline. A 7-point lead for the Panthers, maybe a danger zone here for the Cowboys.
Well, this is why this possession is important, simply because they want to hold serve a little bit. They want to turn it over, want to get an opportunity in the basket, keep the crowd out of it, and keep the deficit somewhat manageable.
Eaton drawing the personal there. Blair, who has been outstanding at 11 points, 9 rebounds per game, and just continues to work and outwork everybody right near that basket. Pitt by 7.
Get in the game. Get in the game.
This holiday season, everything we offer comes with a world of possibilities. Sam's Club. Enjoy the possibilities. Enjoy them when you use your MasterCard.
Oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging. Not only green when summer's here, but also when it's cold and dreary. Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging.
ABC, your NBA destination for a Christmas Day doubleheader. Catch Heat Cavs and Suns Lakers.
New pet.
Chia.
Chia Pets, the pottery that grows. And now, Chia Garfield. And
Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
He's a Chia Pet, too.
Rocky?
Yes, even Shaggy. It's fun. Soak your chia, spread the seeds, and watch it grow.
Chia.
And now there's a bonus gift in every original Chia Pet box. A mini Chia Cuddly or a Chia Alarm Clock.
Chia.
Chia Pets. Collect them all.
Available at Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, and Kmart.
A superstar returns.
4-2-J, he's back!
And a champion fears for the end.
At WWE Armageddon, Chris Jericho takes on the legend killer Randy Orton for the WWE Championship.
And no one is safe. The Undertaker, Edge, and the Animal Batista in a triple threat match for the World Heavyweight Championship. WWE Armageddon. Live Sunday, December 16th on DirecTV Pay-Per-View.
We welcome you back to ESPN's coverage of college basketball presented by Cars.com, all part of Holiday Hoops presented by Kay Jewelers. Pitt on top of Oklahoma State, 29-22. DeJuan Blair's mom and dad, Greg and Sherry, on hand. And his great-grandmother never misses a game as well.
Well, I would say that when you're local hero and you've got an awful lot of tickets to be able to provide game after game, and look at Shari right there. She's the basketball player in the family. She's the one that taught DeJuan how to get it done. Well, she was a 20 and 20 in high school.
She was a double-double average through high school. She was a superstar.
But unfortunately, I guess through injuries, or actually maybe through DeJuan, it was time to give up the shoes, and she's living vicariously through her son.
Now, all smiles as well.
Well,
she
she's on
be.
The cell. Somebody yeah. called her and said, you're on.
You're on and looking good, Mom. 10 points, 3 rebounds for DeJuan as Eton connects. 29-24 Pitt. Oklahoma State coming in 5-3. The Panthers coming in 9-0. Fields trying to get it to Sam Young. He got airborne, left it off of the baseline. They turn it over.
As we say, Pittsburgh doing a terrific job on James Anderson. Obviously, Oklahoma State doing a nice job on Sam Young.
Anderson so far held to just 4 points. He has hit a three, but he has not exploded as the Cowboys probably needed here in the first half. Here's Anderson. Dove. The pass inside. That's batted out. With 9 seconds on the shot clock here for the Cowboys.
You talk about the defense Oklahoma State played on Sam Young. He's only got 2 points in this game, and you know he's averaging 18.8, almost 19 points a game.
Eton with the inbounds. You may remember Byron Eton with that amazing, ridiculous three-point heave in that triple overtime game against Texas last year. He tried a traditional three there, and it's going to be banked up and in by number 33, Marshall Moses, another freshman for this young Oklahoma State team.
Oklahoma State getting some guys coming off the bench now, really providing some effort, some hustle. And what they need on the road, every time you play on the road, you need some energy. We talked about this 13 consecutive game losing streak on the road.
Fields with his jumper. Anderson tried to answer. Knocked Knocked away by Fields to Ramon. Now the three-on-three, quick pass. Oh, look at the dish from Fields to Blair, and he finishes.
And that's court vision, particularly the Vance Fields, knowing where everybody is. And he's trying to save the ball, but he understands exactly where his big man's going to be. You know, Ramon delivers nicely up front, and two guys on Fields. He knows that Blair's going to be around. He just drops it off nicely. And when you got a big guy who's going to run, you know, that's a luxury. But more importantly, when you got a point guard that's going to pass, that's even better for the big boys. And DeJuan Blair, again, freshman who's had tremendous impact on this Pittsburgh team, on the offensive end as well as defensively. Quick feet, good anticipation, perseverance, effort. Can't ask for more.
Already in the first half, the rookie, with his mom and dad cheering him on from the stands, has gone past his season average of 11 points per game. He's got a dozen, along with three rebounds and a pair of steals, so he's all over the stat sheet.
He's going to be one of those stuffers on a consistent basis.
Eaton will back it out and take a look now for the Cowboys, suddenly trending 33-26. Moses will launch a long-distance shot. It rims out to Ramon.
Not the shot that Sean Sutton wants. You got to explore the defense. You got to put more pressure on the Pittsburgh defense.
Fields again. Bit of an awkward-looking jump shot. And that's why he's hitting only 25% of his threes. Here's Eaton. And they're not falling for the Cowboys here.
Quick shots, and that's not really Oklahoma State's game. Yes, they can run in transition, but at this point in time, they need to start getting higher percentage shots to try to match Pittsburgh.
Now that is a good shot for a three-point man like Ronald Ramon, who's at 39% from three-point distance. And here's the biggest lead of the day for Pitt. It's up to 10. Dove on the drive, the fadeaway, left it short. Rebound tip to Harris. He comes back out with it for the Cowboys.
Smart decision. Reset it. You need a bucket right here. Got to really stem this onslaught by the Panthers.
Moses with his fall away. Nothing going down right now for Oklahoma State. They have gone as cold as the outdoors here. Quick turnover there.
Got to be more assertive than the shot Moses took. Talked about him giving energy, but that fadeaway is not what you want, and I don't know what that was.
That was Blair shutting down Eaton with a wild effort up against the big guy. Ramon with a slick bounce pass. Pitt really passing it well, getting the better-looking shots than Oklahoma State. It's back over to the Cowboys. We'll celebrate the holiday season with some college basketball on ESPN Sunday night. Tyler Hansbrough and number one North Carolina taking on Rutgers. College basketball, part of Holiday Hoops, presented by Kay Jewelers on ESPN Sunday night at 8 o'clock Eastern. Hansbrough, the All-American, at 21 points per game and just about 10 rebounds as well.
Great decision for him not to submit his name for the NBA, to come back here and really establish himself as a premier player in the nation. And so far, Tyler Hansbrough has done just that.
5-second violation. Good, tough defense again out of the Pitt Panthers. We talked about their up-tempo style this year. They're averaging more points, about 10 more per game than last year. The defense is as good as ever.
Saying used to dominate this game.
Hey, Mike, you got my shirt on again, man.
No, not this one, Chris. I've had it forever. Gift from my grandma.
Your grandma?
Yeah, Cora. Grandma Cora.
It's got my number on it, man.
You know what, Chris? I'm not going to sit here and have you disrespect Grandma Cora.
Mike.
ESPN, your NBA destination for games Wednesdays and Fridays, plus in-depth analysis all week.
Hurry to get the best deals at your Chrysler dealer during the final days of the event of a lifetime.
Get 0% financing on all 08 Chrysler vehicles, like the new Chrysler Aspen.
And make no payments till summer on all Chrysler vehicles, including the all-new Town & Country.
And the fuel-efficient 30 miles per gallon Chrysler Sebring.
Plus, you'll be covered by the best warranty in the business, Chrysler's Lifetime Powertrain Warranty.
Hurry to save at your Chrysler dealer today, because the event of a lifetime ends soon.
Okay, delivery intercept. Well, say you just shipped the package to New York and it's on its way when your customer calls and says, hey, I gotta run down to DC for a few days. Well, now what? Well, what if you could intercept the package and have it sent back? Or better yet, reroute it to DC. Well, you'd have those options if you shipped with UPS. It's not just delivery, it's UPS Delivery Intercept. Oh, good. Cherry blossoms are out.
Charlie Wilson's War has been nominated for 5 Golden Globe Awards, including Best Picture.
Without Charlie, history would be sadly different.
Sometimes you have to be unconventional to accomplish the unbelievable. Charlie Wilson's War, rated R.
Because the problem with adjustable wrenches is the adjustable part. Black & Decker created the auto wrench. It automatically adjusts with the push of a button. Tough enough for any job. The auto wrench from Black & Decker.
Ryan Burns, Steve Lavin in studio, coming up on the K Jewelers Halftime Report. Set 14 undefeated teams remain in college basketball, 7 on the ESPN family of networks in the coming week. Plus, Billy Gillespie off to a tough start at Kentucky. Is the honeymoon over? It's Kentucky and UAB, our next game. Now back to Dave and Len, guys.
Ryan, Coach Lab, thank you very much. Looking forward to halftime. Right now, Pitt with the 10-point lead. They're shooting 60% from the field. And Len doing a great job shutting down James Anderson. Although he's a freshman for the Cowboys, he's averaging 21 per game.
Well, Pittsburgh is a different breed of animal when it comes to playing defense. And particularly credit to Mike Cook, who has pretty much perfected the strategy against James Anderson, to stick with him regardless of where the ball is. Cook has been face guarding him, denying him, and really made it difficult.
Well, Young took the little bump, but he makes it a 13-4 run. 13-4, Pitt on the move here to open up a 12-point lead.
Well, Pitt very efficient on the offensive end, but Oklahoma State has really contributed. First of all, the turnovers, although that was a foul right there. The turnovers by Oklahoma State, and then some of the quick, probably poor judgment shots that they've been taking during this run.
Fields with the foul, but back to Anderson now. Just 4 points so far. Not many chances either. Just 1-for-3 shooting it thus far.
And again, that goes back to Mike Cook's deny, face guarding, really trying to keep the ball out of Anderson's hands, which is the best way to shut down a terrific scorer. Don't let him touch it.
Nick Sidorkis, 6'4 freshman out of Jenks, Oklahoma. Backup point guard for Oklahoma State. At the line, and another one coming here.
And people talk about how you stop great scorers, and oftentimes once you let them have the ball, it's too late, and you know you're at their mercy for the most part. But if you can deny, and you only have to do it for several seconds each play, because once they, with the 35 second clock, once you go away from a guy, it's rare that you get back to him because the shot clock starts to run down.
Jamie Dixon's team last year eventually knocked out of the NCAA tournament, the Sweet 16, by UCLA in the West Regional. Of course, the Bruins bound for the Final Four. They lost the 7-footer Aaron Gray. They lost Antonio Graves, Levon Kendall from that squad. They were as high as number 2 in the polls at one point last year. Right now, they're number 9. Playing well at home, 38-27 the lead on Oklahoma State.
What irony, getting knocked out by UCLA. Jamie Dixon's predecessor, somewhat mentor, Ben Howland, as the coach. You know, the teacher won that one. But the student, I'm sure, will be back.
40-27, starting to get comfortable here for Pitt. Offensive foul is going to be a shove there, and it'll be number 2 on Bonello.
Another critical turnover, and it's just piling up on Oklahoma State.
And Pittsburgh in the postseason now, last 6 seasons. A lot of Sweet 16 appearances, including last year.
Yeah, and I think the knock on Pittsburgh during those years was they didn't have enough offense to get past the Sweet 16. They didn't have that balance. Terrific defensive team, but at times their shot and their offense would go south. And in a tournament, you can't allow that to happen too often and too long.
Well, Sam Young starting to heat up and find the range. He now has half a dozen points.
I think with this team, combined with the terrific defense that they play, now they've got up-tempo offense, more guys to go to. Could be a different story this year for Pitt.
Ramon off his fingertips and back over to Oklahoma State. Just 2:20 left before halftime. And assuming it continues like this for Sean Sutton, he's got to find a way to get the ball to Anderson in a position where the kid can't shoot it, or it could be a very long second half.
Either that, or he's got to have other guys present themselves as threats for a longer period of time, which forces the defense to adjust and gives Anderson a chance to get open. And also, it's again a question of judgment. This is a young team. We talked about it before. Some bad shots, some mindless turnovers by Oklahoma State has really kind of exacerbated the problem.
Harris with the theft. And now,
see, that's what I'm talking about.
You're exactly right. That's been happening time and time again. Cook jumped in with the theft. Here's Young all the way through on a blocking foul against the Cowboys.
I mean, that turnover by Terrell Harris. Didn't have to throw the lob. You're losing this game by a lot. By 13, you have to be sure coming down the stretch in your offensive sets that you get a good look.
Foul on Ibrahim Thomas. You may recognize Thomas if you saw the HBO Real Sports episode about corrupt diploma mill prep schools, detailing his odyssey from Senegal to something called Florida Prep, where they didn't have enough beds for every player. There were three young men brought in from Africa alone. And even though he wanted an education, he was not allowed to go to classes there. Eventually, within a few weeks, transferring to Stone Ridge Prep in California, where they did go to class. Thomas, very bright kid. He grew up speaking French. He understands Spanish and Portuguese, as he loves Oklahoma State. He's very much at home there.
That probably is the single most important reform by the NCAA to crack down on those diploma mills, the exploitive diploma mills. These young men deserve better than that. And you got to be happy that, you know, they've had much more scrutiny and shut those things down.
Harris cleans it up, lays it in. And a minute 15 to play here before halftime. Pitt with the 44-31 lead over Oklahoma State. Last year was an absolute barn burner, and the Cowboys want to get it back to that here on the road. Jump shot from the corner by Sam Young, and he is the offense right now for the Panthers.
Well, three double-doubles this year, leads the team in scoring, and just so much more comfortable. Had some problems with his knees last year. Didn't seem to be the same player he is this year.
Dug back out. Harris, that's a rounded out. And a foul and a rebounding fray with less than 43 seconds to go before the half. Young has scored Pitt's last 11 points.
Well, he can do it off the bounce. He can shoot the three, obviously. And he's been such a weapon for Pittsburgh with his versatility.
And Marcus Dove going to the line for a 1-1. Dove only 67% at the line. And Biggs there with the rebound. Pitt leading by 16. Oklahoma State last year won 22 games, although not enough to get into the NCAA tournament. A loss today to drop the Cowboys to 5-4. Ramon looking to shred that defense. Back out it goes to Benjamin for the pull-up pop, and he nails it.
Steve Benjamin so solid coming off the bench. A senior with a great deal of experience doesn't mind coming off the bench because he knows he's going to get his opportunity. He injects his team with a lot of energy.
5 seconds left before the halftime horn here. Harris trying to get the shot off. Dove from way downtown. Kind of sums up the way the last 10 minutes of the half went for Oklahoma State. Everything went haywire. Pitt leading by 18 points at the break, 49-31. So Pitt looking very much like a team that deserves to be undefeated right now as they push for a 10-0 start for the fifth consecutive year, 49-31 at halftime. Let's go to the studio now and Ryan Berg.
Thanks a lot, Dave. Welcome to the K Jewelers Halftime Report. Ryan Burt joined by the coach, Steve Lavin, and coach Pitt up by 18 at the half, one of the undefeated teams in the nation. What's jumped out to Pitt? 49 points in the first half. We're not used to the Panthers scoring at this rate. What's jumped out to you?
Well, you know, the sign of a good basketball coach is the ability to adapt and adjust to your personnel year to year, because in college basketball, you're always really recalibrating your basketball team. And Aaron Gray goes to the NBA, and Jamie Dixon and his staff have devised a plan with DeJuan Blair, an outstanding freshman, almost a double-double per game, very skilled, a little undersized at 6'7", but they've utilized his foot speed, his quickness. He runs like a deer, and then surrounded him with young Ronald Ramon and company, and that ability is why right now Pittsburgh is a very tough matchup. They're averaging 10 points more per game than last year. 82 a game right now, 71 last year. Playing a little bit quicker. They can extend, and they're a very tough matchup for opponents.
Now put it in your BlackBerry this Thursday, Pitt and Duke at the Garden. That scoreboard will get a workout. Both these teams look like they will be undefeated. Undefeated is the topic today when we come back on the K Jewelers Halftime Report. 14 remain undefeated, 7 on the air on the ESPN Family Network.
ESPN's coverage of college basketball presented by Cars.com, all part of Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers from the sold-out Peterson Event Center here in Pittsburgh. Dave O'Brien, Len Elmore with you. James Anderson, the Oklahoma State star, averaging 21 points a game, and Lenny in the first half held to 4. He was not much of a factor.
No, he wasn't, and because Pittsburgh's done a great job of taking him out of the offense, 1 of 3 from the field. But if you look at the numbers, Oklahoma State has had more field goal attempts than Pittsburgh, but they only hit 39%. And the most important thing, taking Anderson out of the offense, Oklahoma State has really hurt their cohesiveness. Only 1 assist on 12 field goal attempts. So it's on 12 field goals made. So it's really the Pittsburgh defense that's gotten the job done today.
So as we get ready for the second half, Pitt leading by 18. They shot 68% in the first half.
I guess the offense wasn't too bad either.
Yeah. The Panthers started out 8 out of 11. They never cooled off. On the other side, Oklahoma State started 7 out of 11, but then went 5 for their next 20 from the floor. Doug leans in, and it rolls for him. Well, that's how the ball game started, as Oak State got off to a good start.
And that was a nicely designed and executed play to begin this half. And those are the types of things that Oklahoma State needed to do when they started to fall behind, instead of taking the quick shots and the poor shots that they did for most of the first half.
The real hot hand down the stretch of the first half, not so much Blair, but she gets denied in the paint. It wound up being Sam Young, who scored 13 points after starting out cold. There's Blair with a goal attempt. Count that basket for Oklahoma State.
Two possessions now for Oklahoma State. Two good shots. Blair getting there a little bit too late. Ball had already hit the backboard.
And Blair had a very good first half. He's on his way to a double-double with 12 points and 5 rebounds. Ramon left open for the 3. Can't get that one to go. Oklahoma State, 13 consecutive road losses, trying to turn the tide in a very, very difficult place to win on the road.
Sanderson now at 6'6", has an advantage on Ramon, but he's not exploiting that advantage. Instead, he decided to give the ball up on the wing when maybe he could have put it on the floor.
Eitan pounding his way into the paint and lays it in.
Higher percentage shots. Jamie Dixon not happy about it. Oklahoma State executing much better on the offensive end to begin this second half.
Yeah, the first 6 points of the second half for Oklahoma State. They've tightened it up.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship coming in March.
The new Philips Norelco Architect, a shaver with flexible heads which pivot and rotate freely to give you a great shave even on the neck. Simplicity is making hard-to-reach places easy to reach.
Hi, can I help you?
Yes. Will you pretend you're my wife? Great. Come on.
Happy holidays, sweetheart. Something else?
Yeah, maybe not romantic enough.
Oh, pretty.
At Lowe's, we're happy to help you find the perfect holiday gift for everyone on your list.
What about a gift card?
Yes.
Including Lowe's gift cards. Spend $100 in Lowe's gift cards and get one of these Cobalt tools. Lowe's, let's build something together.
They emerged from the muck, hungry for new Campbell's chunky, fully loaded soup with extreme amounts of meat to feed an NFL-size hunger. And yes, Mom, they washed their hands before they ate. Introducing Campbell's chunky, fully loaded in the black can.
It was a fateful day in Green Bay. For Brett Favre, glory would hinge on a single play. And, true to his calling, he would go long. Because Rayovac lasts as long as Duracell and Energizer and saves you money.
Does he always do that?
Come see us again, Brett Favre.
Thanks for stopping here.
You can't lose. Rayovac lasts as long or your money back.
All right, great. Well, you already love the reliability of the big brown truck, but let's say you're shipping something really big or pallets of lots of little things. Now, wouldn't it be great if you could send any size shipment with the reliability and tracking you're used to with UPS? Hey, look, now you can. It's not just freight, it's UPS freight. Throw some mud flaps on here.
Oklahoma State cutting an 18-point lead down to a dozen very quickly in the opening moments of the second half as we take a look at our game track brought to you by PlayStation 3. 18:37 to play here in the second half. Eaton and Harris. Young with 13, but he started out quite cold. Oklahoma State has two assists on 15 field goals, but those were the first half numbers, which were not good for the Cowboys at all. Improving quickly here in the second half.
Better execution, better shot selection.
Fields finds Ramon outside the three. They quickly guard him. That was Anderson who hopped out to take him on. Shot clock at 12. Pull up pop for Young, and that rolls off. So the momentum obviously has swung over to Oklahoma State, at least at the beginning of the half. Eaton calls out a play now for the Cowboys.
Mike Cook back on James Anderson. Cook doing such a nice job denying Anderson opportunities. Only three field goal attempts in the first half for the Cowboys' leading scorer.
Yep, he could not breathe.
There he is again.
Flipped out of bounds. 10 seconds to shoot now.
It's not enough that Mike Cook denied that. He's lobbying for the ball to go the other way.
And the Cowboys with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Eaton to make his move off the screen. Blocked by Blair. Got it back and another one. And took it right away from him. Back-to-back stops by DeJuan Blair. Cook in transition draws the foul. Lesson learned there by Byron Eaton, not once but twice.
Talk about DeJuan Blair being a bit undersized at the center position, except for that reach. At 6'7", still with a 7-footer's reach. And that's the most important thing. A lot of people want to focus on how tall you are. But when you get in that range, 6'7", 6'8", 6'9", it's really the length that you present. And DeJuan Blair, with that 7-foot-plus wingspan, obviously a guy who can control the paint on the defensive end.
Now four blocks for Blair. Got half of them on that one turn. Eaton decides not to go inside on this possession. Here's Anderson to launch.
And that shot was one out of frustration. Anderson, without a whole lot of field goal attempts, just had to launch that one maybe to feel like he's part of the game.
Cook on the attack again draws the personal foul. Cook, the Philadelphia native, who played his high school ball with Akeem Warwick, now the Memphis Grizzlies, and Mustafa Shakur, who started Arizona at Friends Central High. And Cook with another one on the way. He is a good foul shooter at 82%. He made one of two, however. 52-37 Pitt, but Oklahoma State with the ball. Harris picks up his dribble on the bounce pass, a foul from behind with 16:58 remaining. In the game, a doubleheader of college basketball on ESPN Tuesday night. First at 7, Brandon Rush and number 3 Kansas facing Anthony Morrow and Georgia Tech. And then at 9 o'clock, it'll be Joe Crawford and Kentucky facing the Houston Cougars. College basketball, part of Holiday Hoops, presented by K Jewelers on Tuesday night. Anderson with the bucket, now has six.
And that time with more of a mid-range look as James Anderson, if he wants to get on track, can't settle for threes. He's got, again, be more assertive offensively, get the higher percentage shot.
A floater there by LeVance Fields. A well-run play for the Panthers. Eaton quick dribbles through that pressure. Dove really worked hard on his mid-range jump shot, gets inside, and the shooter's roll.
Dave, each time now that you've seen Oklahoma State on the offensive end, they've not settled for the three per se, except maybe for one by James Anderson. Instead, they've been putting it on the floor, driving, trying to put pressure on the Pittsburgh defense, which really had a holiday in the first half with the bad shot selection by Oklahoma State, the bailout.
A better looking attack so far for the Cowboys for sure since halftime. Fields. Eaton strips it. Yeah, Ramon collided on the deck. He quickly gets up. But now in transition is Anderson with the leaner and a foul, the blocking foul against Pitt. That'll be on LeVance Fields. That's his third. The crowd howling here at the Peterson Event Center.
At Dick's Sporting Goods, we've got gifts you can't buy anywhere else.
Like exclusive Nike ACG and Columbia Whirly Bird outerwear.
Nike Tri-Bolt Fleece.
Or Under Armour Chase Mock Neck.
Only Dick's has Slazenger, Walter Hagen Golf.
And exclusive styles by ASICS and Nike Livestrong.
Custom ESPN table games.
Or Quest fireplaces.
And Field & Stream rugged boots.
We've got the Garmin GPS bundle.
Horizon E900 elliptical.
And PowerTech home gyms.
Or give a Dick's gift card. Every holiday season
starts at Dick's Sporting Goods.
Hey, what you eating on?
See, Chipotle grilled stuffed burrito. It's got the right amount of kick.
Yeah, for a girl. This is the double Hellraiser with cheese.
Whoa! Hey, ho!
You're on fire, dude.
Yep, I know it. Hey!
How's that Hellraiser treating you?
Marinated carne asada steak spiced up with a smoky Southwest Chipotle sauce. It's Taco Bell's Chipotle grilled stuffed burrito. For taste, not fire. Think outside the bun.
Steve O'Dell is a real GEICO customer, not a paid celebrity. So to help tell his story, we hired a celebrity.
Recently, my father was carjacked at knife point.
Oh, honey, that's all right. This face has seen more knives than a Benihana.
GEICO handled the whole thing with unbelievable sensitivity.
Sensitivity? I can't feel my face.
I was so impressed, I switched to GEICO and saved over $600.
I was very happy.
GEICO. Real service, real savings.
Am I smiling? I can't tell, Steve.
This is the story of giving my mom what she really wants for the holidays. I don't know if she was more surprised at what I got.
Let me look at you.
Or how good I looked in it. Yep, I'm glad I didn't go with that crystal turtle.
Whoops.
Whatever your story is, your Citi card can help you write it. Citi, let's get it done.
Oklahoma State's 5'11 junior guard Byron Eaton was down on the other end of the floor after the transition following that collision.
Take a look right there. Ramon flies over Eaton and lands on that right ankle. Another angle right here. Good hustle by Eaton, but Ramon right there on top of that right ankle. No, that's got to hurt.
So Eaton getting some treatment, still hobbled, to remain on the bench. We'll see if they wind up taking him into the trainer's room for continued treatment. And now he's going to try and walk it off. Anderson to go to the line, James Anderson. He became the first man in his first college game to blow up for 29 points for Oklahoma State. He's the youngest player on this team. He's just 18 years old, but he has turned into their scoring leader at 21 per game. When you have a freshman who is, in effect, your leader, and down 18 at half, can you really look to that guy?
You may not have a choice. And again, Anderson has stepped into this go-to guy role because James On Curry made a decision to go on to the NBA, and so obviously Oklahoma State lost him, and that put the pressure on Anderson to step up as one of the more skilled, gifted offensive players in the Big 12. And it's amazing. The Big 12 has got these impact guys. coming in as freshman. Michael Beasley this year, James Anderson, Kevin Durant last year.
Yep, just blowing up. Here's Cook long range and around and out. Whether it was inside the cylinder, he'll get another effort out of this, however, as Young had the rebound roll right to him. And a new shot clock here for Pitt. So this will have to be a long, long defensive stop for the Cowboys. Young, one hands it off the glass. And a good effort by the Cowboys there. Brown's limping, by the way. And it's off the hands of Anthony Brown of Oklahoma State.
Well, now that the deficit is closed a bit, you're Oklahoma State, you definitely want to look for the easy ones. That was just a drop, really, by Brown. A nice delivery on the fast break.
Ramon leans in, and that'll be a charge and offensive foul against Pitt.
Got to give the Cowboys some credit right now. They did not fold. They came out here in the second half with some fire. Started to play a lot better defensively right there. Just an excellent job by Harris to recognize the play and come across the lane to take the position. You got to be aware playing defense, took me on the weak side.
Well, you're absolutely right about Oklahoma State. They were down 18. They can get within 10, doing exactly what they need to do. Harris with the fall away. Yes, nothing but net for Terrell Harris. He can really score it, too. He had 24 against LSU in Maui in a big victory for Oklahoma State.
Oklahoma State looking to try to chase the ghosts of 13 consecutive road losses.
Harris with the tip, stolen away by Oak State.
I mean, it's almost a night and day difference as far as the focus, as far as the execution by Oklahoma State on the offensive end.
And they are chilling this crowd here at Pitt, at least at the moment. Brown open at the foul line, and I mean wide open, could not cash in on the jump shot. Being tipped out of bounds. It will be Oklahoma State's ball. The crowd doesn't like that either. Everything going against Jamie Dixon's team right now.
And the officials confer. Ed Hightower, Curtis Shaw make the decision. It's going the other way. Pittsburgh's favor.
Potentially got it right.
Ronald Ramon got in there and got a little bit of a tip.
And they did change the initial call, and back to Pitt it goes. Eaton back on the floor now for Oklahoma State.
Now it's Pittsburgh that needs to work on the offensive end in the half court, and obviously the turnover right there
by the freshman Gilbert Brown out of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
It was too easy in the first half, shooting 68% from the field, get that 18-point lead.
Eaton. He drags the foot and a traveling violation. And then he looked at Obi Minello and said, you're supposed to go the other way. You went the wrong direction. That's not the play that we drew up.
And both times the ball handler anticipating something that didn't happen. And that caused the travel.
Well, an early tip just after noontime here in Pittsburgh. The crowd maybe just starting to wake up. Or at least they're trying to get Pitt to do that. Benjamin on his dribble drive. He gets sealed at the foul line. Shot clock at 7. Young baseline airborne. Could not get it. Manello leading the charge now for the Cowboys. Stripped and stolen away from him. And a foul in the aftermath.
Obi Manello obviously compounds the mistake in turning it over with the foul.
Picks up his second personal. LaVance Fields back on now for Pitt to run the offense. Pitt trying to go to 10-0 for the fifth year in a row, but it was last season right at this point when they lost for the first time. They fell to Wisconsin.
Well, what happens is when you look at their schedule, it's always one of those progressive schedules. They play some easy teams early, and it gets progressively more difficult in December to try to prepare for a conference play. And playing this team and having Duke upcoming, you know, it's going to be significantly more than Pittsburgh can chew in some respects, and certainly more than they've had to devour in the first 9 games.
Dove fouled by Biggs in the act of shooting, just under 12 minutes to go. And this has turned into a ball game. Pitt's big lead is quickly dissolving here on the home floor.
Are so unchanging, not only green when summer's here, but also when it's cold and dreary. Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging.
ABC, your NBA destination for a Christmas Day doubleheader. Catch Heat Cavs and Suns Lakers.
Okay, give me my remote.
Get it, Jim. You had way too much cable.
You said you were going to get DirecTV.
I'm fine. Really.
So digital picture doesn't mean anything to you? But what about your friends and your family?
I just want to watch the game.
That's the cable talking, Jim. That game isn't even in HD.
Friends don't let friends watch cable. Refer a friend or family member to DirecTV, and you'll get $50, and they'll get $50 on top of our best offer.
The junior LeMans Fields back on to run the show for the Panthers. Pitt head coach Jamie Dixon is one who believes that the team that bowls together is the team that stays together.
Bowling is something else I do in my spare time, and some me and the guys go out, you know, whenever we get a chance, and it's all about being competitive. You know, everybody wants to win and have the bragging rights, so it just helps with my competitive spirit.
That's what I'm talking about. That's big time bowling, baby. I know we play basketball, but that's big time bowling.
I think you can see why LeVance likes the bowling, because he's awfully good at it. Now Pitt, on the other hand, shot 68% in the first half, and it's been pretty much nothing but gutter balls in the second half, Lenny, at 1 out of 8 since the break.
And Oklahoma State is really starting to clamp down defensively, and I think Pittsburgh is relaxed. As I mentioned before, it was almost too easy in the first half, getting all the shots that they want, shooting 68%. Oklahoma State misfiring on the other end. Good defense played by Pitt. When you come out here, you don't have the same fire. And all you need to do is give a decent team, a very good team like Oklahoma State, a bit of an opening, and that starts to build confidence.
They have trimmed 11 points off the halftime deficit and done it relatively quickly with 11:42 to play in this game. Benjamin well outside the three, now inside that line. Shot clock at 14. Fields taking his time. Shot clock at 9. He'll shoot up the long bomb, and he knocks it down.
You always want a point guard who has the ability to stretch defenses, and certainly when the shot clock's running down, to create for others or create for himself.
Anderson pretty much an afterthought in this one. The freshman really getting an education in one of the best arenas in the country. Manello left it short. Fields trying to push the tempo now for the Panthers. Quick dribbles and draws the foul. Dove reached out and fouled him in the act with 10:48 left.
That time LeVance Fields, once again, getting a feeling after hitting that last three, decides obviously he's got a bit of a hot hand and he wants to be able to get foot pressure on the Oklahoma State defense. This shows a little bit of assertiveness, I'm sure, in that huddle over the last time out. Jamie Dixon pleaded with his guys to get that fire back.
Dub with his third foul as Fields connects. The General, his nickname, the way he takes charge. And so far, only 14 turnovers through the first nine games for Fields, as opposed to 52 assists. As Terrell Harris is back on for the Cowboys, and Obi Manello takes a step out. One out of two for Fields. 58-47. 10:40 to go. Anderson swings for Dove. He's become the go-to man on offense. Anderson's three. Not there for him today, and Blair with a strong rebound.
Pittsburgh doing a nice job of forcing Anderson out of his comfort zone. He does have long-range capability, but I think he's probably a step too far.
Just 8 points for him. Rebound tipped and controlled by the Cowboys, and here they come. Trying to cut into the lead is Eaton. The wing jump shot. Anderson again remains cold. The rebound tipped nicely there by Oklahoma State. That was by Brown to keep it alive. And another shot clock for the Cowboys. A whistle and a timeout. Timeout, Oklahoma State. They take one here with 9:50 to go. As Sean Sutton wants to talk this possession over. A few moments ago, look at the defensive effort.
Reason why James Anderson is having difficulty, a lot of it has to do with the defense. You see Gilbert Brown here, but certainly Mike Cook has a lot to do with it. Shadowing, a little bit of ball pressure, but more importantly, look where he's forced to receive. Nobody's given him any lanes, any daylight to be able to raise up and shoot that shot, and Anderson forced to give up the ball. And when he does have an opportunity to shoot, it's usually maybe a step or two out of his range beyond the arc.
Gilbert Brown with the defensive pressure there. He also had a 38-inch vertical leap. Look at the top-scoring freshman, Anderson, right now, number three. Beasley at 25, Gordon at 24. But Anderson well below that right now, just 8 points today.
Well, the reliance on freshmen by a lot of these teams obviously puts them at somewhat of a disadvantage because of the lack of consistency unless you have a superstar. Last year, it didn't hurt Texas any to rely on Kevin Durant. This year, Kansas State riding up and down with the play of Michael Beasley, and so is Oklahoma State here with James Anderson.
Shot clock down to five. Eaton got a look. His three missed badly, and it did not touch the iron. A shot clock violation.
And Sean Sutton really jumped off the bench and is extraordinarily disappointed in Eaton, particularly in not only in the shot, but in the leadership out there in that possession. Eaton was almost too nonchalant with that shot, even though he realized there's like 4 seconds left when he launched it. Little ball penetration might have helped it.
It's exactly what Sean Sutton indicated. Get in. I don't want you shooting out there. Fields, look at the quick dribble behind the back. Nearly lost it. He did get it into the corner. Biggs. Beautifully done by Pitt as they move it inside for the bucket.
And that's the difference between the two teams when they're operating efficiently. Oklahoma State has had a lot of trouble penetrating and moving the ball around because of the good Panther defense.
Boy, Anderson harassed again, did not get a good look, forced that shot, the whistle, and a hold right there at the foul line with 8:47 remaining.
And on the other end, Pittsburgh, when they put their minds to it, they're able to penetrate, move the ball around, catch the defensive rotation, and get a high percentage shot.
Benjamin with the foul for Pitt. But the Panthers again open up a 13-point lead. And now Eaton, after being counseled rather sternly by Sean Sutton after that last wild shot, comes back on the floor for the Cowboys.
Well, Eaton is their true point guard. You can't keep him off the floor very long if Oklahoma State has any chance to win this ball game. But again, it's all about judgment, and coaches need to continue to coach.
On the base. Oh, look at the block by Blair. That's five for him today. Well, the youngster is impressive.
Drive by Dove on the base, but look at the help. And Blair sized it up. Look at him sizing it up all the way, just waiting. Now, offensively, if you're going to deconstruct Dove's move to the basket, he left too much room between the rim and his shot. When you're going to take that kind of shot on the opposite side, you're going to get as close to the rim as possible using the backboard to keep some shot blockers away.
Eaton penetrates a little closer, still can't get it to go. You have to love the joy DeJuan Blair plays with.
Hey, he's home.
He is home, and it is home cooking at its finest for him. And having a big day, 14 points, 8 rebounds, 5 blocks, and a couple of steals.
You know, we talk about DeJuan Blair being at home, but that's not always a good thing for a lot of guys. There are a lot of distractions, particularly the ticket situation, family, everybody asking you for stuff. Doesn't seem to bother DeJuan Blair as he, once again, kind of dominates his way to the basket.
Yep, he's pretty good. 16 for him now. 62-47. Depending on how long, of course, he stays in a Pitt uniform on this campus, he's going to be the go-to man for some time to come.
Look at the anticipation by Mike Cook on the pass to James Anderson. I don't know what that was. He thought he got fouled. But yeah, Blair, you got to be a special person, have a special character to be able to thrive in an environment where you're constantly recognized, constantly pulled aside by people that are close to you.
Harris now with 14 points as he knocks back the jump shot. Quiet the crowd for a moment and a timeout. Pitt 62-50. They lead it by a dozen.
As you mentioned, Dave, nothing like home cooking. And when you're a guy like DeJuan Blair who truly understands, you know, what it means, what he means to this program, what he means to his community, you know, you just have a lot of fun with it. And right there, just done a terrific job of locating the defense and then taking what they give you and saying, yeah, I got more of that.
Well, an athletic power forward with the reach of a guy 7'2" tall. That's special. Celebrate the holiday season with some college basketball on ESPN Sunday night as Tyler Hansbrough, number one North Carolina, will face off against Rutgers. College hoops, all part of Holiday Hoops, presented by Kay Jewelers on ESPN Sunday night at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Hansbrough hitting 55% of his shots, averaging 21 and 10.
Folks cannot forget, though, despite Carolina being number one, the rack, tough place to play. Don't care who you are. Rutgers fans come out, support their team.
Really support their women's team as well. Highly ranked, the top 10 team. Very difficult to beat them there. Young gives off. Here's Blair, a little too strong with a mid-range jump shot.
That's something he's going to have to work on. You can see the rotation and the release.
Manello with the three ball, and he knocks it down. 5 for Obi Manello, and all of a sudden, Oklahoma State, just at that point, Len, when it looks like they're out of the game, they creep back in it.
Well, bending and not breaking is the first sign of a team starting to awaken, starting to understand who they are, particularly here on the road. But you got to get past that.
And the foul. Young wanted the three-point play. He'll be shooting when we come back to try and open up more on that lead, which is 62-53. Pitt at home.
Bye, hon. Find us a good one.
Bye.
With 2 million vehicle listings to choose from on cars.com, you can find the right car for you.
There it is.
Find the right car for you. Cars.com.
Your Double Deep Pizza with double the toppings.
Double.
Pizza Hut's new Double Deep Pizza. Double it up with double the toppings and 50% more cheese. Get one now for just $12.99. Double means more with America's favorite pizza, Pizza Hut. Order online.
Now through Sunday, get no payments, no interest till January 2009 on store-wide purchases of $2.99 or more with your Home Depot consumer credit card.
Charlie Wilson's War has been nominated for 5 Golden Globe Awards, including Best Picture.
Without Charlie, history would be sadly different.
Sometimes you have to be unconventional to accomplish the unbelievable. Charlie Wilson's War, rated R.
This holiday, give him something he'll really love. The Philips Norelco Architect. Simplicity is giving him a gift he'll use every day.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Cars.com. Find the right car for you. Cars.com.
Just a reminder, coming up next, it is Kentucky and UAB. Can Joey Crawford and the Wildcats get back on track? They're 4-3 on the year. Back to Dave and Len at the Pete in Pittsburgh, guys.
Hi, Ryan. Thank you very much. Oklahoma State trying to nudge a little bit closer. Pitt leading it 62-53. As we watch one of the 14 undefeated teams currently in college basketball, the Pitt Panthers trying to go to 10-0. A huge, huge game coming up on Thursday against Duke. 14 unbeaten teams. The chances that somebody will run it out undefeated this year. I know Steve Lavin said they're not strong.
Probably about 10%. I mean, it's just too much equality, too much parity in this game. And playing on the road, very difficult for anybody. I don't care if you're North Carolina, you're Memphis, or, you know, your teams that are having difficulty like Oklahoma State. It's just one of those things. And the other side of it is the consistency level. So many underclassmen that are playing, so particularly freshmen that you rely on, they may not be able to give you the same thing night in, night out.
We're seeing that with James Anderson today for Oklahoma State, 2 out of 8 from the field. So he's had a frustrating day.
So when those things converge, you know, you're gonna have a tough day. But you know, some of the upsets and things like that, obviously, if your coaches are some of the more favorite teams, you'd rather have them happen early than late.
Young with a tap rebound there to Fields, and here come the Panthers. Cook won't wait. His three is on the money. Mike Cook with the bucket. He has 9.
And we talk about Pittsburgh with more up-tempo play, averaging almost 83 points a game. That's an example. The willingness in transition to pull up and take threes.
Dove scoots around on that baseline. And a foul with 5:58 left. It'll be Blair's foul, his third. 20 points, 14 rebounds. His very first college game, a double-double in his college debut. And when you start like that, the expectations go through the roof. But he's playing to that level here today with 16 points and 8 rebounds.
Has he yet not smiled? He's been playing his whole game with a smile on his face.
Yep.
And you got to love that. That's the epitome of a college player having fun. Mama's smiling, too. I guess with those numbers, you can't help it.
Yeah, you mentioned it. It's a special kind of individual who elects to play, you know, just 500 or 600 yards away from his high school to play in your hometown with all those incumbent pressures. Stolen away by Eaton. He strips Cook. Thought about a three. Harris attacking the goal off the dove, and he'll lay it in.
There's a few opportunities Oklahoma State has had to be able to move the ball around, get an assist on a field goal attempt.
The Cowboys with the pressure and almost turned over again as Anderson batted it out of bounds.
I think Oklahoma State senses that they've got some momentum and this may be their last chance to get back into this ball game. So you see the intensity heightened.
Last season, Sean Sutton will tell you, so will Jamie Dixon, was one of the best games of the year. It went double overtime. And Oklahoma State would pull that out. They played 8 overtime periods last year, more than anybody in the Big 12. And it was a school record for the Cowboys. Every time you turn around, they were going OT with somebody.
That was a memorable one against Texas. Mario Bogan hits a 3-point shot, not normally known for it, but he iced it there.
Here's Blair hauling in the rebound. Got the foot down and laid it in. Thought for a moment he might travel, but look at the big grin again. Marcus Dove fouls him. That's 4 on Dove. And Blair attacks again.
Well, this is the bug that Sean Sutton hoped wouldn't bite his team, but far too many second chance opportunities given up by Oklahoma State so far this season. That was a big one right there. Does a lot to mute the comeback effort.
Blair now has 16 points, 9 rebounds, could not convert on the 3-point play. 13-point lead for the Panthers. Eaton, Young, knocks it away from him. Anderson battling for it, batted it right to the middle, can't get the lay-in, however. He had a clear lane to the basket and missed the bunny. Fields on the dish. There's Young, gets it back, and a foul on the baseline.
Actually, no foul there. It's going to be tapped out of his hands. And it'll be back over to the Pitt Panthers. And now the Cowboys are going to bring on a substitute here. It'll be Anthony Brown, the junior out of Brooklyn, replacing Anderson. Just had a very rough day. He had all of 8 points. And 2 out of 8 from the field. Fields gets it into Ramon. Fields catches, fires, got it. A two-pointer. 13 for LaVance Fields.
Pittsburgh getting back to that solid execution on the inbounds play there. Went to second and third options. Got a good shot.
Dove stripped from behind, taken away by Sam Young as he reached around and plucked it. Here's Cook, batted away by Dove on the deflection. Ramon on the other end. Another errant pass by the Cowboys.
And again, a question of judgment right now. You don't need to take risks if you're Oklahoma State. Instead, you've got to make sure that you get an attempt at the basket every time you get possession.
Trying to get it inside for Blair and a foul with 3:55 remaining, and we have a timeout on the court. Nothing but big grins today from DeJuan Blair. If you had that kind of talent, that'd be the look on your face, too.
Kate's texting us from her dinner with Jeff.
He brought her flowers. Oh,
he took her to Chez Francois.
Nice. He went to Jared.
He went to Jared.
Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry, has 5 times the selection of ordinary jewelry stores, so you'll find the perfect gift every time. Only gold glows.
It's for you.
Do you have brothers?
Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
You don't want to be LeBron James. I can inspire you. Impress you. Make you believe. But I am just one man. Nothing about my game is great yet. I still have work to do. More challenges to face. Much more to learn. To be as good as I can be. But I do see the light. And it is up to me to go and get it. James, you don't want to be me. You want to be better than me.
This week on Countdown.
It was a very, very fun, warm relationship.
Why the Belichick-Mangini friendship took a bitter turn. And we'll trace this country boy's steps to Cleveland stardom. Sunday NFL Countdown, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
ESPN, how can I help you? John Anderson is at extension 5634. There you go. Oh, Stan, got a message for you. Production meeting, 2:00.
Oh, the holiday spirit. It abounds at Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky, where the Wildcats of the SEC hope to make Freedom Hall their home away from home for the holidays. They get set for the Blazers of UAB, Conference USA, and the SEC coming up.
And back at the Peterson Events Center here in Pittsburgh. Pitt leading at 71-56, trying to remain undefeated, trying to race out to a 10-0 start for the 5th year in a row. Dave O'Brien, Lenny Elmore with you. Blair at the line. A big, big day for the youngster. 18 points and 9 rebounds. And very cool at the line. He's done everything else beautifully today. 76% at the line. He's also a 55% shooter from the floor.
And so far, Oklahoma State shooting 39% from the field, and a lot of that has to do with their inability to get high percentage shots around the basket in their half court. And you give a lot of credit to DeJuan Blair with 5 blocks, an intimidating presence in the middle.
20 points tying his young career high. Harris off the mark with a 3. And Blair now has a double-double. That's 10 rebounds for him. Oklahoma State also has 3 men playing with 4 fouls, Harris, Brown, and Dove. So that could really knock a comeback right off its pins. The reach in by Eaton and a foul as he lunged out and got Cook. Eaton with the personal. And that'll put Cook at the line. We've talked about the fact that DeJuan Blair's mom was an outstanding high school talent. And Mike Cook at the line here. His mom, Dawn, still ranks as one of Temple's best ever lady rebounders in the history of that school.
And Mike Cook has got a little more of that stellar basketball family lineage. His grandfather, Tom Hoover, terrific NBA player out of Villanova. I'd say back in the 50s, but he's not. He's back in the 60s. But I just want to dig at Tom.
Eaton, difficult shot, can't get the roll. It's back out. Obi Manello will knock down the three-pointer. And coming up on 3 minutes remaining, and Pitt has opened up a very comfortable 75-59 lead.
Remember when I talked about earlier the intensity level that Oklahoma State picked up on defense sensing when they were down nine? This might be the last time they can get back in the ballgame. But a couple of turnovers, a couple of Pitt baskets, and you know that was about it, as Oklahoma State still continues to provide effort. But in the end, they just let themselves down on the defensive end with Pittsburgh shooting over 50%, and particularly 50% from beyond the arc.
Sean Sutton taking the time out here. At 54% for the day for Pitt, 38% for Oklahoma State. The remaining undefeated now. They're 14 going into play today. How about Vandy out to a 10-0 start? DePaul almost got them the other night, but Vandy rallied to win.
Well, tough road win for Vanderbilt as they showed some poise and certainly some grit in coming back because they were down a lot. And let's not forget, last year, DePaul actually went and upset Kansas early in the season, right around this time in last year, in December.
Looking more and more likely that on Thursday, when this Pitt team takes on Duke, they're both going to be undefeated at that point. So a huge early season matchup between two outstanding teams. Pitt trying to go to 10-0. Duke also on that undefeated list. Here's Fields on the long lead. He'll lay it in.
It's like backup for Ben Roethlisberger right there. Sam Young, nice delivery.
A 15 for Fields. Four men in double figures today for Jamie Dixon's team. Manello a little bit too late with this string of jump shots from Obi. Manello is averaging 7 points per game and has 11 today. Backcourt pressure. Ramon out of there with it. Pitt has not had a whole lot of trouble with that at any point this afternoon. Another reach-in foul by the Cowboys, but time running out on Oklahoma State, just 2:12 left. Well, the Wrangler five-star player of the game, no doubt, is DeJuan Blair. And a tremendous afternoon, a double-double, 20 points, 10 rebounds. You talked about how impressed you were by the five block shots.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of the things that keys your defense. Pitt prides itself on defense. Coming into this game, only allowing 55 points. Opponents are shooting around 36% from the field, 26% from beyond the arc. A lot of it has to do with the ability to shut down that lane and force the other guys to take shots that are less high percentage than ones that are in the lane.
Oklahoma State got out of the gate quickly today, making 7 of their first 11. Looked like they were going to hang around, make it a barn burner against Pitt like they did last year when it went double overtime, as Dub knocks it down from close in. And Sutton takes another timeout here with 1:57 remaining. Been very entertaining watching DeJuan Blair, the native of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, on the home floor here today. A look around his hometown.
What's up, everyone? I'm DeJuan Blair, and behind me is the house that I grew up in, 600 yards away from the Pittsburgh Peterson Event Center. And I'm a Hill District native. I know the whole campus better than some of my coaches do.
Well, the next mayor of Pittsburgh has really demonstrated why a lot of people have those high expectations. On both ends of the floor, able to get it done. And he's done it with poise. And he's also done it with enthusiasm.
DeJuan Blair, just a special, special young man. His parents so very proud of him. And that's how you become your city's favorite son.
And as Mike Molinari, our producer, was following DeJuan around to the house, to his old school, and around the neighborhood, people came out from everywhere, from their homes, to give him hugs, to give him kisses, to tell him how proud they were that the hometown kid had stayed home to play his college ball and continue his stardom here. And a good many of them asked for tickets for today as well.
Well, I mean, that's a tremendous support system that you have. And that may be the difference in many respects why a guy like Ron Blair can be successful in his hometown. You know, solid support system, beginning with mom and dad, who are here at the game. He's got everybody in his community behind him. And, you know, even if he thought about getting into some trouble, into some devilment, you got people out there that are watching out for him.
I like that description. Just a little devilment once in a while.
And he's so highly recognized, and I think he seems to be such a responsible young man that, you know, that's something that's not even going to enter into his mind. Yeah. So it's that support system really that will make a difference.
Terrific kid. The foul as Cook went leaning in, looking for the basket. 1:36 to go. And Pitt trying to put the finishing touches on this one, leading by 13. Mike Cook at 82% will go to the line. Harris has just fouled out. That's number 5 on Terrell Harris. And Cook to shoot. Cook with 11 points. As mentioned, Blair with 20. 15 for Sam Young. Fields has 15. Ramon has 10. So Pitt now with 5 men in double figures for the day.
The balance that's demonstrated on the offensive end for Pitt certainly is going to pay dividends down the road. You talk about the matchup with Duke, and, you know, Duke, another team with terrific balance. A lot of really heady, team-oriented guys and some young players that really made a difference. Kyle Singer, Nolan Smith. So, I mean, it's going to be a terrific matchup.
Now, we're saying 14 undefeateds as of right now. That is accurate. Come Thursday, that will not be the case. We'll see if they all escape undefeated after today around the country. Pitt is on its way to doing exactly that and going to 10-0, flipped up by Cook on the drive.
And that's a nice little reward for Mike Cook after the tremendous defensive job he's done on James Anderson with a little assist from Gilbert Brown. But it's been primarily Cook who's face guarded, really started out strong against Anderson, denied him the ball and made it difficult.
50 seconds left in this contest, and Fields reaches out, takes it away on his way through for another basket. Vance Fields with a very effective day as he has 17. And in the end, Pitt will roll to what appears to be a pretty easy victory. Early on, Oklahoma State shooting the ball well. They were right in it. They were down 18 at half. They got it inside double figures on several occasions. But every time they did, Pitt had an answer, and it was usually DeJuan Blair, the freshman. So in front of another packed house here at the Peterson Event Center, it'll be another win for the Pitt Panthers, and they will go to 88-8 here all time. In the 6 years of this building, Oklahoma State will lose for the 14th straight time on the road. That's a problem that Sean Sutton's young team will have to continue to work on. And that will do it. Your final score, the Pitt Panthers, now 10-0, 85, and Oklahoma State, 68. Coming up next, we've got UAB against Kentucky. Blair with the big one, the double-double, 20, 10, and also 5 blocks. For Len Elmore, Dave O'Brien saying so long from Pittsburgh. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Now we send it back to the studio and Ryan Burr.
All right, thanks a lot, Dave. Just a reminder, coming up next, it is UAB, Robert Vaden taking on Kentucky. We have a little bit of time before we get you out to the tip there, so welcome back into the studio, Ryan Burr, joined by the coach, Steve Lavin, and certainly Pittsburgh impressive today. How about the freshman, a guy that rarely gets discussed when talking about this amazing freshman crop, DeJuan Blair, 20 points, 10 rebounds, 5 block shots. Stuffed it pretty good today.
Yeah, and what I like is the fact that he fits in well with his teammates. The teammates are trying to set him up. When you look at LaVance Field, Mike Cook, and Sam Young, they're feeding the big fella, letting him go to work. And DeJuan is a star. There's no question. That's why his mother, he's such a bright star, shiny star. The mother had to wear the sunglasses indoors today. That's impressive. Yeah. That's when you know you're a star.
I thought about wearing them out here with you, Coach, a bona fide L.A. Right. super
good for the self-esteem.
Superstar.
That's a good boost. Good boost.
Pittsburgh stays undefeated. They get Duke at Madison Square Garden. Speaking of stars, what a game Thursday night right here on ESPN. Two undefeateds, two top 10 teams. Who do you like and why?
Well, you know, I have to go with Duke because their overall balance, I think they'll cause some matchup problems. They have a little more size down low. But there's no question this will be a competitive game, a game where you're going to need to bring the brass knuckles, bring the boxing gloves, because Duke, obviously an explosive team. When you talk about Duke this year, it's the cavalry, the freshmen that have come in, the three musketeers, Nolan Smith, a slasher, a finisher in the open court, Taylor King, able to shred the nets from long distance, and, of course, Kyle Singler, a player that can do it inside and outside, has played in the post but can step away and knock down threes, has a great feel for the game. So the three musketeers for the Blue Devils, those freshmen, have really helped. And there's a solid nucleus when you look at Gerald Henderson and John Shire and Greg Paulus, obviously, as well. So a veteran team. And DeMarcus Nelson, people forget about him. He's been around so long. I think he played for Coach K in the early 80s when Jay Billis and Mark Allery and those guys were around.
Yeah, an awesome game right here on ESPN. Yeah, Big East against ACC. Another Big East team going outside the conference. How about Georgetown meeting Memphis this week? That's number four versus number two. Two of the unbeatens. Georgetown going on the road.